Today I'm going to teach you how to bail out of the handstand. Now there are two ways to fall out of a two-arm handstand. We could overbalance, we can fall head over heels onto our back. We can underbalance, where we can fall back towards our feet. Obviously, I'm going to teach you how to bail if you fall head over heels, so you're going to fall onto your back. This can create a lot of fear if you're learning how to handstand. So if we learn how to bail, we take out a lot of that fear, and now we can learn much easier. There are some prerequisites for this bail. You need to be able to, number one, hold a chest-to-wall handstand for 60 seconds comfortably. 60 seconds should not be your maximum. You should be able to do multiple sets of chest-to-wall handstand. Number two, you need some resemblance of a cartwheel. The reason we need a cartwheel is because the ending of the cartwheel is the same as the bail in the handstand. If you do not have these two prerequisites, then you're not ready to actually start freestanding work, so this would be a waste of time to learn the bail at this point. But don't worry, simply work on your chest-to-wall handstand, work on learning a cartwheel. Once you're at those prerequisite numbers of 60 seconds and a okay cartwheel, now we can start to learn how to bail. So I'm gonna show you the full bail, and then I'm gonna show you how to work up if you cannot do the full bail automatically. So when we kick up to handstand and we start to overbalance, what we're going to do is we're going to first take one step with one hand. That could be the right or the left. Then from here, we're going to split our legs, and then we're gonna fall just like we would out of a cartwheel. So if I step with my right hand, I'm going to land on my right leg. If I step with my left hand, I'm going to land on my left leg. You're going to turn the body as this happens, so you're gonna be doing half of a cartwheel out of the handstand. Now, when you start this might be quite scary, so we can start with some regressions using the wall. Using the wall, you're simply gonna go into a chest-to-wall handstand. You're gonna split the arms and the legs, and then you're going to split the legs in the same way. So if your right arm is forward, your right leg is going to be forward, and vice versa. Then from here, you're simply just going to practice the bail from this split position. So it's a static position, and you're controlling that bail so you can get the idea of what happens. Once you're comfortable here, now you're going to start in a chest-to-wall handstand, but now you're going to start with both arms even, and then you're going to take a step, either right or left, and then you're going to bail. So you're going to more dynamically practice this bail and do this until you're comfortable. Then what you're going to do is you're going to get up to chest-to-wall handstand, float into a freestanding handstand, and on purpose you're going to overbalance, take a step, and then fall out. So we're entering the handstand very statically, very safely, and now we're going to purposely overbalance and practice that bail out of the handstand. Now I recommend practicing both sides. Even though you're going to have a dominant side, it helps to understand both, and it helps to bring some balance to our handstand. Once you are comfortable here, now you can start practicing in space, kicking up to freestanding handstand, on purpose bailing, and then practicing this bail on both sides. Once this feels natural, now you'll be able to naturally, when you're holding it and you overbalance and you're not ready to correct it, that mechanism is going to click in and you're going to be able to bail very smoothly. Now I recommend, even if you feel confident with this bail, I recommend starting at regression one, just doing a couple reps on each side, and if it feels good, moving on to the next progression, and not simply jumping to the full progression of the bail just because you think you can do it, because you might end up getting injured in some way. So please build up from the first progression all the way to the last one. Now there are many different types of ways to actually bail this way. We can fall into bridge, we can roll out, we can actually walk in the handstand. But I find that this way, the cartwheel out, actually gives us a lot of efficiency and doesn't overtax the system. So if we're falling into bridge every single time, we're going to get fatigued very quickly. Or if we roll out every time, we're going to get fatigued very quickly. But this way is simply a step and a cartwheel out, so there's not really a lot of effort in the bail. So when you're kicking up and falling, which is going to happen if you're learning a handstand, you can get down, come back up very quickly, very efficiently. Now this particular video was actually suggested by many different people, so if you have any suggestion for a future video, please let me know in the comments down below. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments down below as well. If you have a friend that is learning how to handstand, please share this video with them. It'll save them a lot of trouble as they go down the road. I will see you in the next one. That's the session.